Carolina the Band!
Let's do it, guys.
Oh,
Lord, for us to be here tonight and be with our friends. Thank you for being so gracious to us, so kind to us. If you smile at us when we sing, we think you're enjoying it. If you're not, just keep on smiling because they'll never know the difference. This past November, we were honored by a magazine called Cashbox. They're one of the magazines that charts songs nationally in different genres of music. And on their Southern Gospel chart for the month of November, we were blessed and honored with the number one song. Did we sing that for you tonight? It's from the pen of the late Dion Wilkinson and our friend Lee Black. Listen to Scott sing about the stories that are on your walls.
It's just a little house in a little southern town where the kids can run and play till the sun starts coming down. Folk who live there love it, couldn't leave it if they tried. There's a garden and a porch swing and lots of love inside.
Signature song. We've been singing it now for about the last 6 years. It reminds us that men and women have fought and died and sacrificed to keep this country free. And those who want to take that away, well, the songwriter said, "I have to go through me, because I'm an everyday American." Listen to the voice.
We believe he is the most awarded drummer in the history of Southern gospel music. Why is that? Because for over 20 years, he was the drummer for the Mighty Kingsmen Quartet from Asheville, North Carolina. His dad, the late Eldridge Fox, that is Little Foxy, our Hall of Famer, Mr. Greg Fox. Will you make him welcome from West Jefferson, North Carolina? Standing behind me is 21 years of age, incredible talent. He is so gifted. I call him the magnificent Mitchell Wisdom from Conley Springs, North Carolina. How about Flash? Will you make him welcome? That's Mitchell. And of course, standing next to me from Wilmington, North Carolina, Andy King. He was a member of the cast of the Carolina Opry for about the last 5 years or so. About a year ago, he joined us. He's a Carolina boy now. We are so thankful for all he does. Takes care of our stage for us. How about Mr. Andy King? Would you make him welcome? And my singing buddy now for over a quarter of a century. Yes, that's a long time. Literally, this is a worn-out Southern gospel joke, but it's true. We have socks older than Mitchell. That is the truth. We have been singing together a long, long time. I still believe he's not only one of the greatest singers in the business, but he is one of the most incredible communicators of a song. That's Pastor Scott Whitner. Will you make him welcome? Pastor Scott. We have three Chrises in the group. We have Chris Parker, we have Chris Powell, and we have Chris Roberts. So when I earned a doctorate a few years ago, Scott, Tim, the nickname...
Doc
on me, yes.
Why? Because it's hard to earn a doctorate in anything. But this guy has an earned doctorate in church worship, and he's the best I have ever watched work at.
Jack Coltrane, Master Man.
No, sir. He is awesome. We stood together about 28 years on the stage. He said we got socks older than Mitchell. We've been on the road longer than asphalt. They ain't no doubt about it. And we're glad to still be doing it together after all of these years. He is invincible when it comes to singing first tenor in a quartet. My good buddy, my best buddy, Dr. Chris Roberts, right here.
How about let's get all of Carolina? Will you make the guys welcome? So, we do travel with a full band. And when you got a band, you have to feature the band. So, they were messing around in rehearsal one night. I said, guys, what is that? They're like, we're just jamming. So we call this the Carolina Jam. Play it, boys.
Thank you.
minutes after that.
You got your phone?
Have I got my phone? Yes, sir.
I just really feel impressed to sing this song. You talk about a new song. This song, we just got the master version of this back. It's co-written. Co-written, yeah. Got a doctorate, sure do. Thought I'd prove it to you.
North Carolina thing.
Rip, wrote. We got it from our producer, Wayne Hahn, and Reba Rambo McGuire. And this song is going to be released on Stowtown Records on May the 1st, I believe. But since we've already practiced one on you, I'd like to practice another. This is brand new. Y'all are the first live audience to hear this song. But we've been blessed by this song. And I felt like as soon as we can start blessing others, we need to start singing. It's a takeoff of scripture. What does it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his soul? I want you to listen to Scott sing a brand new song.
We build on the
that song for somebody, and thank you for being so kind to us. Yesterday was a momentous day in the history of Christianity, for we observed Good Friday, the day of the crucifixion of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. You know, at Christmas time, we celebrate Jesus' birth. But yesterday, folks, when Jesus died on the cross for us, we got the gift. I want you to listen as Parker sings a great song about the Lord and Savior.
He was born in Bethlehem, they say. There was a star to light the path to where he lay. Rich or poor, they came.
The world might be saved. Can you say amen?